morning. Good morning on Thursday. Good morning, Ruth. How is everyone today? Anybody else joining us here today? Okay, we've got a few people there. I think we can slowly start. So if I just first remind that the following workout is for intended for fit and healthy participants with no pre-existing medical conditions or any injuries. And we always encourage you to take an extra care when working out with us, and just listen to your body and stop if you feel any pain or any discomfort. And also just to remind you that neither myself or Two Riversmeet Leisure Centre is taking any responsibilities for an injury sustained during those online workouts. So yeah, you're taking part in those exercises at your own risk. Right, so we've got that out of the way and we can start with class. So we're gonna start sitting down today, and I'd like to include a little bit of, again, hip mobility movements and exercises in today's class later on. Right, okay, so let's sit on the mat. So find your sit bones. So give yourself a few seconds just to arrive your body on the mat. And those legs, you don't have to have your knees bent as much. If you like, you can bring your legs a little bit further away if that makes it easier for you to stay on top of your sit bones. In a nice upright elongated position, and then you don't have to have your feet flat on the floor. If you're moving your legs slightly away, you can have just your heels down on the floor, that doesn't matter. More important is this area here, your hips and your back, your upper body. Okay, and then relax your shoulders, a few nice breaths in through your nose and out through your mouth, and again breath in through your nose, expanding your chest, and breath out, and a couple more. Inhale, just focusing on your breathing, trying to connect your mind with your body, focus on your core, on your shoulders, keep them relaxed, long neck, gentle brace in your tummy, and a breath in, bring your arms forwards, exhale, fold your neck and gently lean forwards, rounding your back, and rebuild your spine. Breath in and breathing out again, fold your neck, feel those vertebrae rounding in your spine, rolling forward slightly, and again rebuild your spine, and this time open your legs and just lean a little bit further and come back, close your legs, inhale, exhale again, and back on top of your sit bones. Let's do it one more time. And bring it here, bring your arms out to your sides, and then rock your body to one side, side bend, reaching with your arm up, breath in, and breathing out, switch over to the other side, stay heavy on your hips, And switch again. Inhale, reach up. Push both hips down into the floor. And switch. Breath in, reaching up, lengthening the whole side. And then back to the center. Bring your arms forward, breath in. Breathing out, fold your neck. Just round your spine and roll your spine towards the floor. And then take a breath in and breathing out. Slowly roll it up and rebuild your spine. Open those arms and side bend. Stay. Look down on your hand that is on the floor. And then look up at your hand above your head. And back to the center. Bring your arms forward, breath in. Breathing out, fold your neck, roll your spine down towards the floor. Inhale, exhale, reverse. Rebuild your spine, open those arms and side bend over to the other side. Inhale, stay, exhale, hand up. Look down on your hand that is on the floor and then look up. Your hand above your head and then back to the center. Bring your arms forward. Inhale, exhale, fold your neck, roll your spine down and stay here. So you keep your shoulder blades above the floor, folding your neck and then lift your right knee up. Breath in. Breathing out your left knee up and then stretch your leg and flex and stretch and flex and stretch and flex. Breath in and out. Once right, once left and stretch and flex and right and left. One more each side. And then stay with your legs in the tabletop position. Bring your arm, your head down. Arms out to your sides, creating T-shape with your upper body. And then roll your legs side, side. Trying to use your core muscles here without pushing with your arms off the floor. So relax your hands, relax your shoulders. Breathing in, breathing out. One more each way. And then back to the center. Take a breath in, breathing out. Arms forward, head up, shoulder blades off the floor. And bring your arms overhead, stretching one leg. So the same with your legs as we just did, arching your arms to it. So reach, covering your ears with your arms. And in, and stretch, and flex. Breath in and out. Eyes gazing ahead, so keep looking between your legs ahead of you, not up the ceiling, just to keep the neck folded, chin to your chest. And feel those vertebrae in your lower back, staying in contact with the floor. One more each side. One last switch and then hug your knees, bring your head down, relax your neck, relax your shoulders, and again, arms out to your sides, T-shape, roll your hips, your legs to one side, stay, stretch top leg out and switch
and stretch your leg, and switch, roll your hips over, stretch, flex, and roll over to the other side, and your top leg, stretch, flex, and roll, and stretch, flex, and roll over to the other side. One more each side. One last switch. Back to tabletop. Lift your head up, shoulder blades off the floor, and then double leg stretch. So both legs and your arms. And again, breath in, stretch, and flex. And stretch and flex. Breath in and out. So correct your postures, making sure you've got your lower back on the floor. Eyes gazing ahead. Or keep looking down on your belly button. And reach and flex and stretch and flex. Let's do two more. One more. Back to tabletop, head down, relax your neck, relax your shoulders. Arms out to your side, T-shape again. And roll those hips to one side, stretch both legs out. Legs and roll over to the other side and stretch, flex, and switch. Relax your arms. We're not pushing off the floor with your arms. It's all controlled by your core, your tummy muscles, your lower back. And stretch, flex, and switch. And stretch. Flex and switch. One more each way. Stretch, flex. One last switch. Back to tabletop and then bring your feet down one at a time, slowly lower them down. And then just roll your legs to one side and stay. And just try to enjoy the stretch going across the your back and your obliques. You can turn your head the other way and switch sides, roll your legs, your hips the other way, turn your head opposite direction. And again, enjoy that nice stretch. Deep breath in, breathing out back to the center. And bring your arms closer to your hips. And we're going to go into shoulder bridge. So starting with tilting your pelvis, scooping your tummy in, and then slowly roll your hips and your spine up. Breath in, breathing out, reverse, bringing one vertebra by one down on the mat. And again, inhale. So feel first your hips tilting, your pelvis tilting, tucking your tailbone under. So that's before you even start taking your vertebra off the floor. So this is just that initial movement. Initiated by your core, so really strong tummy muscles holding that, and then peeling, almost like you wanted to pull with your core muscles, your hips, your pubic bone towards your chest, bringing up, up, up. Take a breath in and then breathing out. Feel that nice wave going through your spine, articulating your spine. One vertebra by one, down on a mat. And again. Roll up. And slowly down. So if it's done correctly, you should already feel your core muscles slightly tired by doing that exercise. So don't focus so much on your legs pushing your hips up. Keep focusing on your core. Down, let's do it one last time to bring those hips up and then stay in the shoulder bridge, and then one leg at a time, just lifting knee up and switch and switch and switch. And again, keep focusing on your core here, holding your body still, holding those hips in place. And then lift your knee up, stretch your leg and gently pull, reach forwards and switch. Knee up, stretch, pull, reach forwards and switch. Knee up, stretch, pull, reach forwards and switch. Knee, stretch, pull, reach forwards, foot down, stay. Bring your arms overhead, take a breath in. And breathing out, stay with your arms, just roll your spine down. Slowly, one vertebra by one, hips touching the floor last. And then hug your knees and just roll it side to side. And then fold your neck, shoulder blades off the floor. You can hold your hands underneath your thighs. And then just start rocking your body. Rolling up and down on your spine. Keeping your neck away from the floor, so it's just up to your shoulder blades. And then one last time to bring yourself up, to stay sitting up. And slowly lower your legs down on the floor. And then stretch your legs. And let's focus on our feet. Flex and point. And flex and point. So try to stay right on top of your sit bones. You can have your knees bent if that makes it slightly easier, better when you've got your hamstrings a little bit tight. Or sit on a block or on a cushion or blanket. Just having your hips raised above the floor, it really helps here. And let's do it one more time. Keep your feet flexed, stay. And then bring your arms forward. Keep your left arm forward. Open your right arm. Bring it behind your back. Follow the hand with your eyes. And return. And switch side. And return. And open. Rotate, close, and switch again, one last switch, and then open your legs slightly wider, corner to corner of the mat, and again the same, bring your arm behind your back, stay, and lean forwards. And back, close your arm, switch side, open your left, look ahead and lean forwards and back. This time rotate, switching side, rotate a little bit further to bring that front arm in front of your or across your opposite leg. So if you've got your left arm, bring it across your right leg. And lean forward, return, rotate back to the center, switch side. So first your arm is opening and then add rotation even further to bring that front front arm across the other leg and lean forward, bringing your hand across your foot and return, rotate to the center. Let's do it one more each way. Open, rotate further, lean forward, center, switch, inhale, rotate further, exhale, lean forwards, and bring it back to the center. And then bring your feet closer in, bending your knees, but keep your legs slightly wider than your hips and staying heavy on your hips. So without moving your hips off the floor, just roll your feet on the floor and moving those legs side, side, nice and easy first. So just enough to practice that mobility in your hips. Just as much as your body is allowing you, just to stay within the range of your movement. And then hold here. Bring your one knee in, pulling your leg inwards, and hold there. And then engage your muscles of your leg and try pulling that leg further down, closer in. It may not move, it doesn't matter. Keep moving, keep trying rather. Keep pulling those muscles and pulling that leg in. And release, switch side. And roll in. And keep trying, keep contracting those muscles, keep using them. More breaths in as you're doing that, and out. One more breath in and out, and release. Perfect. Now into your 90-90 or Z sit, it can be called as well. So you've got your leg in front of you in 90 degrees, leg out to your side, slightly behind in 90 degrees as well. And just first rotation. So staying down on your hips without too much movement in your legs, just rotating your upper body, bringing your hands over to your sides, once to your right, once to your left, and switch, and switch. And then bring towards your bent knees, up towards your feet, to the side where your legs are, and stay. And then switch over to the other side and stay. And then back to the center. And then gently lean forwards and back. Lean forwards and back. So this is last time when you can have your hands on the floor, and then we're gonna take our hands off the floor and just lean our body forwards, allowing this leg to bear the weight of your body. Do it as slowly as you need. Just one more time, and back, sitting up tall. Now let's focus on the leg behind you. You're gonna lift your foot off the floor, keeping your knee down. Okay, so you would lift and up and up and up. Okay, so it's that lift. Keep trying. And four, three, two, last one. And then keep your foot down, bring your knee up, lift and lift and up. And and lift. Bring it up. Up. And four more. And three. Last one. Perfect. And switch side. Okay, so again, 90 degrees in your knee and 90 degrees in your leg behind here or up to your side. And rotation first. So rotate side, 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 side. Trying sitting up tall, staying sitting up tall, pulling through the crown of your head, shoulders relaxed. One more each side, and then bring it away from your legs, and your hands away from your legs, and stay. And then rotate towards your feet, towards your legs, stay here. And then back to the center. And gently lean forwards and return. Lean forwards and return. And again. Last time with your hands, and from now on, no hands. Perfect. Let's just do a couple more. And last one. Wonderful. And then focus on your leg behind you, your foot off the floor. So you keep your knee down and just lifting your foot. Bring it up and lift. It's not big movements, just teeny tiny. Actually coming, that foot is coming off the floor ever so slightly, just probably a couple of centimeters, and that's it. So don't worry if you can't lift it too high. If you can't lift it at all, perhaps use your hands and just pull by the trousers to help a little bit. I don't want you to pull by your leg, though I don't want you to damage your joints, your knee. So don't force it, but if you just gently hook your fingers underneath your, or inside your trousers, and then gently pull and pull. To give that initial help, and then see if you can go without help. Okay, and then foot down, keep it down on the floor, just lift your knee up and lift. So focus on that rotation here in your hip. Perfect. And lift. And lift. So try to stay fairly still in the upper body as much as you can. Wonderful. And just two more. Last one. Perfect. And release. And then again, bring those legs to the front and just roll them side to side, loosening up. Wonderful. And then bring your feet together and try to bring your feet as close to your hips as you can, so you can hold your feet. I always find this way easiest. You can just put your hands around your ankles here, and then try to use your arms as well, gently pushing down on your knees and your thighs, but try actually not to use your arms first. Just let those legs relax. Let those muscles relax. Let the gravity do the job. And a few seconds in this position, and then breath in. breathing out, use your muscles of your leg of your legs and pull those knees down towards the floor. Keep pulling, keep trying. Go to the point where you feel this is it. I can't go any further. Stay there. And again, let's try it a bit further. Breath in and breathing out. Let's move those legs. Even if they're not moving anywhere, keep trying. Keep contracting those muscles. Keep engaging them. And then stay in that position. Let the muscles get used to that one. And again, breath in and breathing out. Just try again a little bit further. Again, if it doesn't feel like they are going anywhere, don't worry. Just keep trying. You're still stretching those muscles, even if they are not physically moving your legs. And one last breath in and out. Slowly release. And then close your legs. Bring your hands behind your back and then legs together. Roll them to one side and switch over to the other side. And again, switch. And switch. And switch. One last switch. And back to the center. And then bring your elbows down on the floor and lengthen your spine, lift your chest up, pull your shoulders down, lengthen your neck, engage your core, and then lift right knee up, stay, breath in, left knee up, stay, and just rotation, side, side. If you need to, bring your hands underneath your hips here and just help that way. But keep focusing on using your core and roll those legs and your hips side, side. Now bring your legs over to your right, stay. Stretch your legs, flex and roll over to your left, stay, stretch and flex and roll and stretch, flex and switch, stretch, flex, switch, stay. Now stretch those legs, keep your legs long, take a breath in, breathing out, switch over to the other side, so you've got those long legs, bend your knees. And short legs, roll over to your right again. Long legs, roll over to your left and flex. And to your right, long legs again, and over to your left. Stay, take a breath in, breathing out. Over to your right with long legs, then flex and short legs over to your left. And stretch and long legs to your right, short legs to your left, stretch and roll, flex. One last time and then bring it back to the center, long legs, bend your knees, bring your feet down. And lie down, stretch your legs down. And just relax for the moment. Bend your right knee and slide your foot alongside your leg. So your foot is in contact with your leg, creating a number four with your legs. And then place your foot down on the floor, bringing your knee up. Then take your foot off the floor, so you're in a tabletop position with your right leg. And then bring it across to the other side. You roll your hips, keep your shoulders down on the floor, both shoulders down on the floor here. You don't have to bring your foot down, just bring it across. And then back to the center, foot down and slide it down. Switch sides. So you bend your knee, your left leg, sliding your foot alongside your right leg, keeping your knee down and your foot towards your leg. And stay there for a few seconds. And then foot down on the floor, knee is up, and then lift your leg up with the knee bent, and then roll your hips, bringing your leg across to the other side, holding both shoulders down on the floor. Breath in, breathing out back to the center, foot down, stretch your leg down, and then bring your arms alongside your body. Take a breath in and lift your head up, shoulder blades off the floor, arms off the floor, your hands pulling towards your feet. And then take another breath in and breathing out, start peeling your back off the floor, one vertebra by one, bringing your arms so your hands are on your shoulder level throughout, and then coming up, gently rounding your spine. We're not going down here, just gently reaching forwards. Flex your feet here and then point your toes. Take a breath in and breathing out, roll your spine down. Bring your arms overhead, engage your core, breath in. And breathing out again, your arms, your neck, and stay here. Take a breath in. Breathing out, continue rolling your spine. Peeling it off the floor, and gently rounding, opening that lower back, stretching it out, and flex your feet. And again, inhale, point your toes, exhale, roll down. Arms overhead, take a breath in, engage your core, so you keep your lower back in contact with the floor. Head up, shoulder blades off the floor, stay here, take a breath in. And breathing up, continue rolling your spine. Flex your feet, stay here. And then extend your back, reaching up and rounding your back again. Extend, keep your shoulders down, your arms, sort of extension of your back. Keep that gap between your arm and your ear here. And round your spine. And extend. So you're right on top of your sit bones, pushing your tailbone behind. And then almost tucking your tailbone under now when you're rounding your back. And again, extend. And flex. Lower your arms down. Find those sit bones, rebuild your spine. Bring your arms out to your side, hands at the temples or behind your ears. Lower your shoulders down. Take a breath in, rotate one way. Breath out, return. Inhale, rotate and return. So it's very important when you do that rotation that you're starting climbing up. lengthening your spine rather than going down, sinking in. So you want to go higher, taller, taller, and return. And again, coming up, up, taller, taller, and return. Let's do one more switch the other way. Back to the center, and then stretch your arms out, lower than down. And then bring your legs out to your side and sit on your side. Bring your elbow down. And top arm, bring it up, bend your elbow, stay with your elbow pointing up to the ceiling. This is mainly to help you to keep that area square, open, avoid rotating here in. And then push your hips up off the floor. Stay here, top leg, stretch it out, and bring your leg up and down, and lift, and up. Two more, bring your leg up, stay, flex your foot, bring it forwards, point your toes, push it back, and forwards, and back. When you bring it over behind your back, feel the nice stretch in your hip flexors here, and pull it forwards, push it back, one more, and then back to the center, bend your knee, and sit down. Hips down. Now, create a diamond shape in your legs. So your top leg, bring your foot in front of your bottom leg. And then your hand down on the mat. And from here, it will go slightly away in front of your shoulders. Once you lift your hips off the floor and you stretch your leg, then your shoulder will be right above your wrist. And reach up and over. And then bring it down again. Okay, let's try it again. Engage your core and lift up and stretch. Inhale, exhale down. And one last time, bring it up, reach and stretch, and flex. Sit down and switch sides. So first, on your elbow, on your hip, knees bent, legs together, arm up, bend your elbow. You can keep your arm long if you like, and just mostly it's about holding those shoulders square. And breath in, reach those hips up, and bring it down. And again, lift up and down. Bring it up, stay. Your top leg stretch. Let me just move a little bit further here. And then lift your leg up and lower down. And up and down. And lift. And up. Two more. Bring it up, stay, flex your foot, bring it forwards, point your toes, push it back, and forwards, and back, bring it forwards, all the way behind your back, one more time, front, back, and release, and then come up on your hands, and again, diamond shape with your legs. Your top leg, your top foot is coming in front of your bottom leg. If I turn around this way this time, so you can see my feet. Your arms slightly in front of your shoulder, because once you will lift your body up, stretching your leg, then your shoulder should be right above your wrist. Reach with your arm up, lengthen your whole side, your body, and bring it down. Inhale up and stretch, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down, one more time, bring it up, stretch and reach, and down, and then sit up, Roll your shoulders down to the back. Bring your arms behind your back. Either just leave your hands on your lower back or bring your hands together. Pull those shoulders down. Lengthen your neck. And release. Take a breath in. Breathing out, hug your shoulders. Remember which arm is in top. Fold your neck, round your back. And then rebuild your spine. Open your arms, breath in. Breathing out, the other arm on top. Hugging your shoulders. And fold your neck, round your back. And rebuild your spine. Open your arms. And then gently lean forwards, round your back, and return, and then switch legs. So the other one is in front, and exactly the same. Lean forwards, round your back, and rebuild your spine. Perfect. And then just to finish off, one last challenge. Try to stand up from sitting with your legs crossed. Sometimes one way it's easier than the other, so we're going to try both ways, okay? So you can use your hands, see if you can do it. Have a little test, how it feels, and then come up. Stand up, 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 up. Lovely. And then just stay standing up for a few seconds. We're gonna do a nice roll down, keeping your legs crossed. So deep breath in, breathing out, fold your neck and just rounding your spine. Bring those vertebra down. And take a breath in, breathing out, roll your spine up. And then sit down, so exactly the same way. And then let's switch side. So your other leg is in front. And then again, just give yourself a few seconds, a few tests, how you're gonna do it. And then when you're ready, let's go. Come up. And then lengthen your whole body, lengthen your spine, your neck. Breath in and again, breathing out. Roll it down. Inhale, exhale, roll up. And then bring your feet parallel to each other. And one last deep breath in, arms up, hands together. And breathing out, lower your arms down. And that's it for today. Well done, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this workout today. Have a wonderful rest of your week and weekend, and I will see you next week. Bye.